Welcome back to Chrono Cross. I spent a little bit of time separating out my elements and stuff. We're gonna be using Kid in this next area along with Glenn. I decided Guile needs a little bit of a break. It's kind of up to you on what you want to do here, but that's just what I was planning to do. And we need to get off here at Arnie Village because we got some things... Well, I want to say we got some things to do, but we got places to be. Come on, you two. We gotta go to Opasa Beach. Because we need to head back to our world. Opasa Beach. Yeah, so this is it. The point of contact and the starting point. This is the cross point. They say different things depending on who you've got with you. What do we do now, Surge? Well, let's go forward. Let's see. Nothing yet. Oh, what was that? A wormhole that crosses dimensions. The world's calling you, Surge. Call on the last piece of the puzzle. So this is the dimensional wormhole that connects the two worlds. All right, so here's what you do. You go on top of it, and then you go and you go Astral Amulet. It's not the quality of the video that you're watching. It's just straight up, it's just the quality of the game. Yeah, it's fuzzy and it's not great, but we made it through anyway. It's very pixelated. I'm not sure why it is when everything else has been pretty nice. Huh, that was it? So now we are in that other world. I still cannot believe it though. All right, well, let's head back to our home world. Music's back to normal. You can actually tell where you're at by the colors of various places. So Arnie Village in the homeworld is got all the red, I don't know, awnings, I guess. But if you're in the other world, they actually have blue ones too. Let's see here. Oh, it's you, Surge. So you want to go to Water Dragon Isle? Perhaps you should go ask the old guy by the pier. He doesn't seem too busy. I'm sure he'll be willing to help you. Interesting. Wait, no, what? Go up the thing. Okay, so you may recall there was a girl that does poems, and in this world she's doing poems, in the other world she's given up. There's another me that gave up writing poems? That's a good one, Surge. I never knew you were the romantic type. Then you know, I think I'll give the other me this. It's a compilation of all the poems I've written. Hee! Here, let me just sign my name on the cover, and... Here you go, Surge. Come on, take it. It's embarrassing. Well, send my regards to the other me. I like how everybody is just, like, going along with it like it's, like, normal. Yo, Surge, have you heard your message from the day from the Record of Fate? It's a green pyramid. Oh, right. Did I talk to this guy? I don't know. I was actually hoping he would say something about his siblings, but nope. Alright, so we want to grab that because there is something we're going to want to do with that. I don't think anybody really has much to say here, but let's head to the pier because we want to take the boat that's here to where we're going. Hey, what's up? Surge, where have you been? You had me worried sick. You just suddenly disappeared from the beach. That was some magic trick. Don't even think about pulling that one on me again. Once is enough for me. Yeah, this is the Lena that's not in our party. Huh? Oh, it's you, Surge. Great day, huh? How's your day been? What was that? You want me to take you to the Water Dragon Isle? Well, it's not too far, so I'm willing to take you there for 100 gold. Alright, let's go ahead and go. Surge paid 100 gold. Great. Shall we get going? So because we don't have a boat in the home world, we have to ask the ferryman to take us. I love the music. It's so peaceful. Ho-ho, it's been a while since I visited this island, but its beauty never fades. But there's something strange. I don't see any of the fairies that usually dance around the pond. Oh, pardon me. There's a small village of fairies on this island. It should just be beyond this point. I don't know what brings you here, but it's best to ask the fairies if you want to learn more about the place. In the meantime, I'll be around here fishing. This pond is great for fishing. If you took the path and you have Razzly, make sure you bring her with you. You're gonna want to have her in order to get her level 7 tech, if I remember correctly. And yeah, so just be aware. Okay, I think we want to take this one. And this one. Can you jump on it? Thanks. We're gonna pick up a couple items before we move on. So if you go up here, it's kind of hard to tell, but you can actually climb this spot right there, and then you can grab this aqua ball. I want to make sure I have Glenn with me. Razzly is also pretty good in this area because she can do a lot of damage to the enemies that we're going to be facing. So obviously I can't have her because I never recruited her, but it is something to keep in mind. Can you let me get it on? There we go. Yeah, this one takes you over here. And over here we have an ice blast. Okay, let's get back to lily pads. In the other world, this place is completely dry, so we were actually able to explore it a little less confusingly, which is nice. I mean, it's a nice little fun puzzle. It's not too hard to figure out where you need to go, but still, it's not something that I like want to spend all my time doing, to be honest. Is there something in here? Oh, that was an iron. Sorry. But there is you can pick up an iron underneath the waterfall, because there always should be secrets in waterfalls. Let me save here. All right, well, let's go. What brings humans here? If you intend to intrude, you will not be given a warm welcome. This land is the new home of the dwarves. The dwarves are not welcome here. Be gone with yourself. Or humans are not welcome here. Be gone with yourselves. Okay, so if you have Razzly with you, I would suggest killing everything you possibly can. There is something that needs to happen in order for her to get her stuff. Figure out the words. Level 7 tech. Because we're not doing that, I'm going to bypass fighting everybody for right now. And we're just going to head straight in. I will not tolerate any humans trespassing beyond this point. Defy me and you will face the consequences. I'm actually not entirely sure how many battles you would need to fight in order to trigger what needs to happen. So the best thing you can do is just kill everybody. Make sure you bring Razzly though, because if you don't bring Razzly, then it's a moot point anyway. Okay, the hi-ho chorus here is annoying. First of all, it's gonna hit everybody, but you can actually bypass it by, I think, killing a whole bunch of the dwarves. Let's see here. Can you actually let me hit? Okay. Let's go ahead. We're gonna use a magma bomb here. Now, these guys are yellow elements, and opposite of yellow is green. So Glenn's gonna be really useful here. Using green elements would be really useful. The reason why I'm using the magma bomb is because it does hit everybody. So that's the whole goal, right? Is to hit as many people as I can, do as much damage, which will take care of a few things. Let's go ahead and use another magma bomb, this time from Kid. Looks like a couple of them are starting to sag. Let's go ahead and take them out using Glenn. Now, Glenn. Glenn is green elemental anyway, so he should be able to take these guys out easier because he does more damage. I think the Hyo chorus, I don't know if it can happen now or not. Let's go ahead. He actually does have the magma bomb himself. So let's do that. That'll make it easier for the other two of these guys to do damage. Plus, that will make the field effect completely red, which will help Kid. Yeah, we're doing a ton of damage, which I am loving. Alright, so Kid, hi, poo ho, is, what did that say? I don't think he's too happy about being left alone, by the way. Okay, Glenn's definitely gonna be able to take him out here. Okay, good, and we're back to those fantastic. And that was considered a boss battle for whatever reason. And we get 4 Electro Bolts. Grr, such strength. It seems I've underestimated you humans. This will not happen a second time. Retreat. Talruf. Beardduff. Are those the names of the dwarves? There are some items we can get in this area, but I'm gonna hold off until all the dwarves are dead and we've moved on. Actually, I do wanna grab these two. Really grab this one here, it would be the easiest one to I think there's an item in here. Oh, there is no item in here. There's one up above. We'll go get that when we come back. Now, this would probably be a good time to do some fighting on the dwarves because we just fought a boss battle, so we can get some levels. Let's fight these guys. Okay, just wanted to fight those guys so we can get to the save point. Okay, just wanted to get that save point there. Take a moment, and then we are going to continue down to wherever we're going. So first things first, let's go ahead and grab this chest here. No, this treasure is mine. I'm not giving it up. Okay, so we can grab a scaly dress in here. Not too bad. All right, I'm gonna avoid all the other battles at the moment because we do want to fight yet another boss. Humans helping fairies, you surprise me. However, there's no way I can allow you to leave here alive. You will pay for not heeding our warnings with your lives. That is a tank. Oh no. All right, so let's go ahead and start by doing a little bit of damage to the guys to the left and right. I wanted to do 1, 2, 3, and then I want to use, I'm gonna get hit in the face with a shovel. And then I want to use, not a magma burst, we want to use a magma bomb. This will do a little bit of damage to the dwarves, because that's what I want. Not just damage to the main tank, but I also want to do damage to the little dwarves, because those guys are completely annoying. So let's go ahead and do that. Okay, so he's going to use the element shot. The element shot is going to be whatever color is on the left and right, and it looks like he's going to be attacking Surge here. He won't always use... I don't entirely know how it chooses who it's going to attack and what elements it's going to attack, but there does seem to be... I actually can't use my magma bomb because I messed it up. All right, I'll just use a physical attack then. Yeah, I didn't hit my third attack, so that was annoying. All right, Glenn, let's go ahead and focus on the hi-ho tank. Now, Glenn is a yellow element, or green element, so he's going to be doing a ton of damage. I actually want to go ahead and get that other magma bomb off first. I was hoping to get one off from both him and Kid in order to take out the little dwarves, but obviously that didn't work. That's just a basic physical attack. It does some damage. Should be okay. Okay, so took out the little dwarves. He's probably going to put some defense on himself now that we've taken them out, but I'm not too worried about it. I want to use a bushwhacker. I put it on the 6th level in order to do as much damage as possible. 917 points of damage with the bushwhacker is pretty good. I'm sorry, that's the bush basher, isn't it? Whatever green element that fits over there is the one I was thinking of. All right, let's go ahead and do... Oh, okay, fine. Well, we're gonna go ahead and use another one from Kid. Okay, so she only did 99 points of damage, but that's fine. For Glenn, if we can go ahead and do some damage here. I want to use the, I want to use the dash and gash. First, that is his skill, it's not an element. Special to Glenn. Okay, he's going to use another element shot. This one's going to be yellow. We're probably going to need to heal this next round. I'll use Surge to cast an element. You not. Yeah, like I said, we're going to need to heal. That's okay. Let's go ahead and start by doing one. I'm going to go ahead and use... What do we have here? Let's go ahead and use a heal on Surge. I know it's a heal minus one, but it'll be okay. We do need to keep him alive if we can. That would be nice. I'm gonna need you guys to hit. Okay, he's gonna do just a melee attack on Glenn, it looks like. Let's go ahead and finish up with a single attack. We did give a heal all to Kid. So let's go ahead and do that. It won't heal as fully as it normally would since it's on the first level, but that's actually not too bad, and that should keep us going. I do actually need my guys to hit with the attacks. Let's see. Let's go ahead and use another Bush Basher on these guys. Glenn being green and doing green damage. 120 points is pretty good. Okay, now our field effect is completely green at this point. So let's go ahead. As long as he... Oh, nope. He just split it up using blue. Which is going to hurt because he's doing it on Kit. I don't think he'll do 200 points of damage, but it's still going to hurt. Yeah, we gotta be careful with that. All right, let's keep going here. Did we get it? We got it, yay. We didn't lose anybody and we were fine. Okay, so we got all healed up. I got a knee pad out of that. Nice. Grr, such strength. Are we to be driven off our land once again? Is there no land on this planet where we can live in peace? Oh, goddess of fate, why were we dealt such a hand? Are humans really the greatest species on this planet? These heretics of evolution, these destroyers of the planet... Planet? Ugh. Surge, there's a fairy over there. Surge, is it all right? Who are you? I will be fine. The other fairies, are they all right? I do not feel their presence in the caves anymore. I am sure it is safe outside as well. We're sorry, but wait right here for a minute. We need to go further into the cave. It will only be a little while. Okay, so we're gonna head into the cave now. We really can't do anything else, so just go. Welcome, son of man. Now come to me. Thou need not explain. I know already what thou seekest here. there is not to be surprised about. It is but a trifle for we sleeping dragons who have dwelt upon this land for ages. Mount Pyre, the land thou seekest, is home to the fire dragon. Unless thou quench his red blazes, it will prove a difficult journey. Take this, son of man. My breath can freeze even boiling lava. Alright, so we get... Surge has been bestowed with the ice breath. Take my subordinate as well. It shall be useful in holding back the fire dragon of Mount Pyre. Surge has been bestowed with the frog prince. Okay, we'll talk a little bit about the frog prince at a later point. Wilt thou change this world, or wilt thou change thyself? Wilt thou live on with thy mother planet, or wilt thou turn thy back on the planet and tread another path? That sounds suspicious. Okay, we're gonna get a little cutscene here. If you have Razzly with you, you can't get this cutscene. If you somehow manage to do this before getting Kid into your party, which I think you can do on the save Kid path, you will also not get this cutscene. But because we took the leave Kid path and don't have Razzly, we get a cutscene right after this. They said that they were chased out of the forest by the humans, and they drifted down to our island, so the humans are to blame. Because of you humans, our village, our friends, have been made victims. Why can't humans live in harmony with nature? Why do you continue to act the way you do? Don't you see what the outcome of your choices will be in the future? Why? Why? You crooks, I hate all you wicked humans. Hurry up and get off this island. A very sad tragedy, triggered by the acts of humans. We have lost so many of our people and loved ones. Although our village has been saved, no one here thinks kindly of man. I am extremely sorry, but please leave the island as soon as you can. And Kid fainted for some reason. Probably a reasonable reason to faint. Is that Lynx? Why are you standing in a burning building, dude? Where am I? I fainted, huh? That fire does not look like fire. I love it. Sorry, did I wake you up? I had a bad dream. Seeing that fairy's eyes filled with tears over losing her friends, that must have triggered memories of me own past. I was an orphan. I was abandoned when I was a baby. There was someone who took me in and raised me as if I were her own little sister. I'm alive here today thanks to her. There were a lot of others like me at Sis's place, and she was always making strange stuff. We didn't have money, but we were all happy. Up until that Lynx bastard came and shattered our happiness to pieces. Lynx raided our house, burned it down, and kidnapped Sis. Sister never came back. Since then, I've wandered the world and experienced so much pain just to get by. No one was there to help me. I was always alone. If you ask me, the idea of guardian angels watching over us all the time, that's a load of rubbish. In this world, the underhanded always get the last laugh. Only the ones who don't think anything of hurting others end up getting what they want. The ones who kill, the ones who devour, they're the ones who survive. That's the only rule of this world. The great species of mankind, our wonderful world, filled with love and happiness. Ha! Don't make me laugh. But if that's how it is, that's fine with me. As long as I'm alive, there ain't no going back. I'll abide by this world's rules and do what I gotta do despite the rotten hand of cards I've been dealt. I'll make sure that bloody bastard pays for what he's done. I will get even no matter what it takes. Okay, so we are back in here. We, well, let's actually get to the save point, first of all. We have to take the lily pads back. So if you forgot how to get through all the lily pads, well, it sucks for you, doesn't it? Let's get to that save point first thing. I would like to save now that we've actually gone ahead and beat the dwarf boss, and then we'll talk about some of the other stuff that we unlocked before we got yeeted into some cutscenes. Alright, so we are good to get out of here. I think there was one thing we missed from all of that, but to be completely honest, if I remember correctly, it was like a... it wasn't anything exciting, so I'm not gonna worry about it. And we'll be able to come back here later anyway and get whatever we missed. I don't think we're going the right direction, by the way. In fact, I know we're not, because that's going to lead us over to the other side. Let's try that again. Okay, I think if we go this way... and then go down, we are good to get out of here. Huh? What's going on? The old boatman's gone. Did he head back to the village because we were so late? I figured you'd be coming back out soon. So I got the old boat out. Everybody safe and sound? Oh, many pardons. It didn't look like you'd be coming back before sunset, and I had to return before it got dark. Well, since you made it back here, I guess you did what you needed to do, but you guys looked a little too gloomy for it to have gone well. Alright, let's get out of here and head back to the village. You sure? Then let's head go back to the village. Just lowering down my notes so I can see what we need to do next. At this point, actually, we are at the point where we're going to be moving on into Mount Pyre. So it is actually a fairly reasonable point to take a pause. If you haven't hit up the various stores to pick up new supplies, you should probably do that. Let's see. Let's head out of here. I want to head to the other world because there is one other thing that I want to do today that has nothing to do with the main story. And in order to get back to the main, or to the other place, you just come back here, you use the amulet, and you'll go into the same cutscene as you did earlier. In fact, I think this cutscene will always happen, but you can just bypass it by pressing, well I'm pressing triangle, but I think Y is on Xbox controllers or whatever button it is to bypass on PC keyboard. So yeah, you can see there's blue hangings. Which is really cool. Anyway, so we got that book of poems from the one chick in our home world, and we want to go see the chick in the other world. If you want to talk to her and have a whole bunch of conversations, you can do that now, but I just want to go ahead and use the book of poems while standing next to her. What's this? There's no title on it. Looks like a pretty shabby book. There's something written on the cover. A message from the author? Let's see here. You will find hope within despair. One who does not experience sorrow cannot appreciate joy. Good luck, me! This is my handwriting. It is, isn't it? So there's another world where another me is pursuing my dream. Thank you, but I can't accept this. I just wouldn't feel right reading this now. One day, I too will write a book of poems. So just look forward to it until then, okay? Once my book is finished, I'll give my first copy to you. When the time comes, please place it alongside that one. Thank you so much. I don't know if it will be any use to you, but I want you to have this. And we get a rainbow shell from her. That is the first one that we can get. We'll talk more about those a little bit later, but I actually want to go ahead and look at a quick one that we happened to get from that whole thing that we just went through. Let's see if I can find it in here. We have the Frog Prince. Only if innate color is blue, summons Frog Prince to perform a water attack. This is one of our first, I guess you could call it a summon. I think that's what it's officially called. But the summons, you have to have the field color be completely blue for this one, or whatever color of the summon that you have. And once that's the case, then a person with this summon who is color blue can then summon the Frog Prince in order to attack. Now you'll see here that there's like a little star next to it. It says star Frog Prince. Well, that's where the star levels come into play. So if you look at the bottom left, as of right now, we have 13 stars. We can cast that spell 13 times, or that summon 13 times. You have to use one of your star levels to do that. Now, you don't lose anything by using the stars, and so there's no really point to keep them, and you can get them back by resting. So as of up till now, using the inns was basically useless because it just healed your HP, but it actually also recovers your stars. One of the things that's going to happen, we're going to talk about, I don't know if we can actually get that dialogue now. I can go find out. But the lady up in Termina... I'm stuck. I'm stuck on the dude. What the heck? But the lady in Termina that runs the smithy talks about rainbow items. Let's go see if we can get that from her. I don't think there's really much else we need to do here. If you haven't stopped to get the new elements, now would be a really, really good time to do that. You're gonna need some blue elements for where you're going, so make sure you're ready with those. But yeah, if you talk to this lady, she will tell you that there are rainbow items that, can you just open the door? That you can get to make really good armor. Actually, let's see, do you say anything about it right now? Let's see, let's go ahead and exit out of here. Do you know about this? There is an amazing material called rainbow that can be smithed into very fine items. When we were young, we went out to search for it ourselves, but never found it. We stopped searching when Karsh was born. Children are far more valuable than any treasure, you know? But that man hasn't been shut down yet. Who knows, we might yell out that he's going back on his search. Alright, so yeah, these rainbow items can be gotten using the summons. In fact, I think that's the only way to get them. So, from here on out, what I want to do, if there's items that I can get, rainbow items that I can get in order to make this stuff later in the game, I'm going to show you how to do that and probably get the items that I need, because otherwise what ends up happening is later in the game you have to grind to get the items, and no, I'm not going to do that, especially since, unfortunately, they're good items, but it's not like something you have to do in order to beat the game. So if you wait too long, you may just like be put off by the amount of time you have to put into like grinding. So I don't want to do that. I'll be showing you how to get those rainbow items as we go. And getting the Frog Prince and using the Frog Prince is one of those things that we need to do. All right, let's go ahead and jump in the boat, and we're gonna head to where we need to go, but we're not gonna start it today. Yeah, since we're entering the next arc, I don't really want to, I don't want to continue today. We've already done so many things. Let's see here. Pyre Shore. This looks about right. Does it though? So we've got Mount Pyre East, and we're going to be going in here. I'm gonna grab this item before we move on. We get a magma burst. You can't get that item if you use the ice breath. Now, one of the unfortunate things is, did you see how much damage we just took? Yeah, that's the thing with this area, is you have to be cautious. If you walk into the lava, you take an obnoxious amount of damage. I think we can save at this point, which is gonna wanna do. But I wanna go ahead and make sure that I heal up before going inside. You can use whatever you want. I have so many tablets at this point that I think it's fine to just use those to reheal. And next time we're gonna go into Mount Pyre and start dealing with all that. I will see you guys then.